Hi, this is David with EdgeStar Technical Support. Today here with me we have the FP series of portable cooler freezers. I'm going to show you basic installation and operation instructions. All right, here we have the FP861. Now this is the biggest one in our current FP series portable cooler freezer room lineup. We have three different models. We have this one, of course, the 861. We have a 63 quart FP630 and a 43 quart FP430. This one is an 86 quart, obviously. So they're all the same with the features and the controls. Everything's the same. The only difference between all three is simply their physical size. So what I want to do is I want to go over all the features, what comes with the unit, and then we'll get into operational stuff here in a little bit. So the first thing I want to do is show you it comes in the box, and everything is going to be packed inside the unit when it gets unpacked out of the shipping carton. You're going to have both of your AC and DC cords, the baskets, and your owner's manual. So I'm going to open this up and I'll show you what comes in here. First thing I'm going to pull out is our DC cord. This is a standard issue male DC cord, and then you have a specially keyed end on this end of it for polarity purposes. We'd never ever want to change the polarity on this unit. It is polarity sensitive and you can destroy the unit if you hook it up backwards. It's only keyed one way to prevent you from doing that. So there's our DC cord. We also have our AC cord. And this AC cord, this is 120 volts, three-prong American plug. These can be plugged in at the same time. And I'm going to tell you about that. You can plug both the AC and DC in at the same time to the unit. And AC will be your primary source of power. Now, if AC fails, DC will automatically take over. So in answer to some popular questions that we get, yes, you can plug both of them up at the same time. So not only do you get your two cords here, you also have two different size baskets. This allows you to divide up what you have in the unit and provide you with some organization. So we have a very small basket here. And by the way, there's a lip down in here, and they just sit on top of this lip. And we have our bigger basket. And that's a pretty good sized basket, but that goes in a deeper section of the freezer. Now, you don't have to use the baskets. You can remove them, but I like them for the fact that they organize things. So, and you can lift them out with the food in it, and it makes it easier to carry as well. Your lid has a solid one-piece rubber gasket that's fully insulated with a hard plastic liner. We have a hard plastic shell around the outside. Everything is easily cleanable. The inside is an extruded aluminum. You can actually use just plain water and soap to clean it. There's really not a lot you need to do as far as that goes. And during long-term storage, the one thing I would recommend is that you just find something to just kind of keep the lid propped open a little bit, and that'll help you from getting any smells or anything that's funky building up inside of there. So that'll help you keep it aired out. So I'm going to talk about some of the stuff on the outside. As you can see, we have two latches. They're just a standard locking latch. And then on the ends of the unit, we have two handles. They are spring-loaded. You have also have your controls here on the front. Now, one of the things that we're going to talk about here in just a second is our vents. These vents, there's three of them, and I'm going to show you the other two here in a minute. It's very important to keep at least 6 inches of clearance around these vents. They must not be obstructed because we can overheat the compressor, the unit won't cool, and ultimately your food may spoil on the inside. So we want to make sure that we keep enough clearance. There are three of these vents. And as you can see, there's another one here. It's a smaller one. There's an identical one on the back side as well. There's no difference in that vent. This vent and the one in the back are fan forced. That means there's a fan in each one of them. And what it does is it pulls air in through the side and pushes it out through these two vents. So again, that really makes it important we don't block these vents up. Now, on some of these units, the older units, they have a drain plug. This one is an early production model. And here's your drain plug. And they just pull out like that. And then, of course, you'd have your water flowing out if you had an overflow. Now, I will tell you that on your current unit that you have, odds are pretty good that it does not have a drain. The newer units, they've omitted the drain on them. There is no way to add a drain to it. In that case, you would simply just tip it over to drain it. One other thing that you'll notice here, and of course we talked about the handle as well, is our latch strap here. This keeps the lid from opening back up too far, so it acts as a stop. So as you can see, it keeps the lid from swinging all the way back. One other thing that I want to cover here, and actually there's a couple of things I want to cover back here. Now this is the back of the unit. Now over on this side, as you can see, there's that other vent that I was talking about. We have a model label back here. Now this model label is very important for a couple of reasons. Number one, we have the main serial number here on this barcode. If you call into customer service for any reason, you need to have that serial number with you because it's the primary way that we access your account so that we can help you. There's also some helpful information here: voltage, current, refrigerant type, how much refrigerant. All of those things are covered in here. This is helpful for a technician, along with a basic electrical diagram as well, and that will help the technician should they need to troubleshoot the unit in the future. The other thing that I want to cover back here, and as you can see, we have some pretty nice hinges here. These hinges are the upgrade hinges from the standard hinges that the unit comes with. Your unit will have plastic style hinges. They look a lot like this, but these are stainless steel. We offer these as an upgrade. You can call customer service, you can and ask for these hinges, and we will sell you these hinges. They're $9 each and $9 shipping. We'll go ahead and sell you these. These will last the lifetime of the unit. You may find that the plastic ones are sturdy. They may hold up for many years, but we do have them as an option if you choose. All right, right now I want to show you a little bit about the controls on the unit. I'm also going to show you about the DC and AC cords as well. So we'll go ahead and cover that material. So the first thing I want to do here is I want to fire this unit up so that you can see what the display looks like. Now, remember I told you earlier that you can run DC and AC on this unit at the same time. Down here there's a label. It gives you some important things to remember, that to remember to plug it into the right spot. And you have DC and AC actually marked. And on the DC cord, remember I told you the polarity is very important. Not only is the plug keyed one direction, but the outlet is also keyed one direction. It's almost impossible to reverse the polarity. So I'm going to show you how that plugs in. And the square end on this unit, the square end goes in this direction. So we can just plug up the unit just like that. Now this, of course, would go into your DC outlet, your power outlet, or your cigarette lighter, depending on what kind of vehicle you have. So I'm going to plug in the AC here as well. Now, the display is going to go into a brief self-check, and then it shows the current temperature in the compartment. Now, you may notice initially when you plug this unit up, it may spike up a few degrees before it actually stabilizes. And what's happening there is that the temperature sensor is sampling the air inside the cooler, and it will automatically adjust after it self-calibrates. So we have a brief interval there where it's going to calibrate, it's going to fluctuate a little bit, and then we'll get down to the actual temperature that's in the compartment. That may take a minute or two. And as you can see, it's changed already, so it's still sampling. The first thing that we want to cover here is our fast freeze function. Let's say that you go to the store and you're going to buy a bunch of frozen food. We need to get this unit down below freezing as quickly as possible. Now this unit goes down to -6. And if we hit that fast freeze button, it goes into a fully automatic operation. You don't need to adjust anything. So I'm going to hit that fast freeze. And if you look here on the display as well, not only do you see your temperature, but there's also an indicator light. Green indicates the unit's in a normal running mode. And during that time, you may hear the fan, and you may hear the compressor run. If you have enough ambient noise in the vehicle, you may not. But those noises are perfectly normal, and that's the air being pulled through the unit. So what we're going to do is hit that fast freeze. Now we have a red indicator light and a double F. We're headed down towards -6 now. You don't need to do anything else. If you decide that you don't want to do the fast freeze, to cancel it, we hit the FF again. Now, you can set the temperature on this unit very simply. And what we're going to do here, so I'm going to show you how to do that. This unit will actually run from -6 to 50 degrees. You have a pretty good range there on the temperature. So what we're going to do here is hit the set button. You'll see the current temperature, and it's going to blink. It's waiting for your input. So let's say I'm going to go down to negative 6. Why not? So we have negative 6, and then you can adjust that up to wherever you want it. So I'm going to go up to, say, 20 degrees. Now, it's going to pause, blink. During that time, it's setting that temperature into memory. It's going to default back to the current temperature inside the unit. And remember, I told you it's going to change a little bit until it stabilizes. So that's our operation on this unit. I hope that this do-it-yourself video has helped you to install and maintain your new FP Series portable cooler freezer. If you have any questions or concerns, please contact EdgeStar at www.edgestar.com.